The new normal. What the heck is that? Well, there was the old normal, the way life was, and now there's the new normal, the way life is now. So your loved one probably went through some sort of medical problem, put him in the hospital, brought him back out. Maybe it was a hip injury, maybe it was a heart problem. Something has brought them into the hospital and back out. And now life is a little bit different than what it once was. And there's two key areas that I want to zoom in on today. The first one is the risk of falling. You know, 60% of people that fall after they've already been to the hospital and they're at an elderly age, 60% of them never come back out of the hospital again. So this is a real key area to make sure that we keep everybody away from falls as much as we can, because it really debilitates people. The other piece is either under or over medicating, all right? So we want to stay on track with what our doctor has assigned us in terms of medication. Those are the two big reasons people end up going back into the hospital, which is what we're trying to avoid. All right. First step out of the hospital, what do we got to do? We got to call your primary physician and set an appointment for about a week, okay? We want to have 1 week, and during that week, what we want to do is we want to journal what is going on. Do we see anything that's a little weird in this new normal time, right? We want to track what you're eating. Maybe there's things that don't taste right to you anymore. Let's journal that. Maybe we're not having bowel movements anymore. Ugh, that's not fun, but we've got to journal that. Maybe you're in a lot of pain. Maybe there's a reaction to any of your medications that have been taken. All these things are keys to go back to your doctor, and your doctor is there to create a solution for these problems. So we want to make sure that we're doing a really good job and having a journal. And I provide a journal to every one of my clients as we start with care. So you just go through and you put together all these notes, and then when you're at the doctor's office, doctor, here's what's going on. All right, great, let's move on. So medication, we talked a little bit about medication. How important is medication? Well, it's very important. They have pill boxes. I'm sure you're already aware of that. They have very various organization to each one of these. They're very simple, very inexpensive. They have very elaborate things that can pop a pill out and do all these things. All that matters is that we're writing down the medication and we're sticking to the plan and making sure that it's very simple. And if your loved one has a hard time remembering things, then we need somebody there, whether it's a caregiver or a family member, to remind them of when to take the medication. Okay. Equipment's very important. Do you have a walker? Do you have a wheelchair? Do you have a hospital bed? Do you have all the things necessary in the house? Maybe you need special undergarments and other items that you didn't really plan on having to get. Those are all things that you need to have when you're home, or you need to run out to the store pretty quick and make sure that you can leave your loved one behind when you do that. So you got to make sure that they're taken care of as well. So let's get into this. Activities of daily living. That's like the buzzword out there of what it means to cook, to clean, to get dressed in the morning, to go to the bathroom, to bathe yourself, to maybe shop, to drive anywhere. Anything that you're doing on a daily basis that was part of the old normal that we all take for granted, what are you doing now? Can you do all these things, and can you do them safely? You know, driving is usually the first thing that the family will come to you and say, oh my gosh, you know, this, my parents should not be driving, you know? And so all these different areas of life now have changed drastically, and you got to make sure that you're going after this as safe as possible, and you have the time and the resources to make sure that you're doing it in the right way, and that's what a caregiver's for. The other real big piece out there is loneliness. You know, when somebody goes through a big crisis in their life, with their medical crisis, realizing the age that you're at and all these elements, it can be depressing, you know? And there could be a need for actual therapy and psychologist, or, you know, really just having somebody around, having family members checking in, having a caregiver there, you know, it's just having that person around. We need people to interact with, and that's gonna increase our energy, increase our behavior, and really push down some of that depression. So we need to look at make sure that we're tracking all the things the doctor is asking us to track, and that could be, it could be vital signs, it could be blood pressure, heart rate, things like that, your temperature. It could be any sort of physical therapy that we're trying to do on an ongoing basis. You know, a lot of people in this situation, they're not super motivated, raising your arms up and building those muscles at that age. But these are really keys to getting better and be able to work on your own and maybe get back to doing some of those activities of daily living. So hopefully those tips work for you. Please check out more of my website at slohomecare.com, and I think you're going to find lots of good tips for you there. And I hope to talk to you soon. Thanks.